Good afternoon. It's a great joy to be here. I'm coming to the end of a 5 weeks visit in the U.S. and looking forward to going back to my family and the saints in Sierra Leone. And what better way to end my trip in the U.S. than to be here with the people of God. Thank you so much for the warm fellowship. Although once known as the Athens of West Africa, Sierra Leone sadly still has an adult literacy of only 48%. And since over half of the 8 million population we have in Sierra Leone cannot read or write, we say the need for quality education cannot be overemphasized. So through the work of EduNations, which was founded by Reverend Dr. Dean Weaver and his friends 19 years ago, we have been able to build and operate 15 schools. And this year, we have a roll of 3,700 students and an employee of 150 staff, including 128 teachers. Thank you. It is important to report that all these schools are in rural communities that are hugely under-resourced, so that if EduNations was not there to provide education, the children in these communities would never have had an education. The challenge to providing this education to these students remains in finding resources to pay teachers' salaries, feeding the students in the boarding home, providing school supplies, uniforms, clean drinking water, and toilet facilities. One of the beautiful things about our work in Sierra Leone is that out of these schools, by God's amazing grace, we have been able to plant 6 Evangelical Presbyterian churches and to start 18 outreaches in different communities. Thank you. With support from the Presbytery of the Alleghenies and the leadership of Reverend Betsy Rumor, we have baptized hundreds of Muslim converts, discipled hundreds of new believers, commissioned 32 ruling elders who work with the 8 commissioned teaching elders to lead these churches and outreaches. Thank you. Yes, on a daily basis, we are actively reaching out to thousands of local speaking Timni, Susu, Kuranko, and Fulani tribesmen and women in Sierra Leone, which unfortunately still has 78% Muslim population. Under the tutelage of our friends from the I-10, we are currently training 33 young men and women who are sensing a call into Christian ministry. And I know Mike Kuhn is preparing to go back to Sierra Leone this August to continue with that training. After that training, we anticipate that we would be able to make inroads to other rural communities to bring the gospel. Someone has said that the 2 major challenges of planting churches in Africa are the lack of men and the lack of means. In Sierra Leone, we celebrate the abundant provision of able men and able women who are eager to serve the Lord. So our prayer is for the means. And we thank you so much here at the EPC for the many ways that you continue to resource us as we engage our people. May I end my greetings by asking the assembly to kindly pray for Sierra Leone as we again hold our presidential and parliamentary elections on Saturday, June 24th. Please pray that we would have peaceful elections and there will be a smooth transfer of power. Thank you.